Here we are looking at a six spindle cone where the setup man is looking at the cam in there. We'll take another look at that in just a second. Good. Want to run it? Go ahead. Can you run it for me?
Right.
You wouldn't want to do that. I can understand.
This one cuts off 2 pieces of cycle hook.
On opposite sides?
Yep. One piece on this side and one piece on this side.
Right, right. One is being cut off right now. All of this is controlled by the cam up here on the top. Very slowly rotating.
All your slides, yep. Slides are all operated by them cams on top.
Right. You sort of take as much as a day and a half to set this up, right?
Yeah. All according to how technical the pilot has to be.
Yeah. Now it's all in there. Good shot. That's what you do. Just to get that. The rugged machines, though.
They got dates here on some of them, the patent numbers. You got August 31, 1937,
36. Wow. These are in use. Get
that index in the camera. Stop comes up, pushes it out the piece on top.
Yeah, beautiful. The operations you've got on here basically include
we got drilling, we got yep. Turning, we got forming, and then we got boring on the bottom.
Okay.
The first position would be right here.
Yep.
And that drills and turns. Drills the ID and turns the OD.
Okay.
And then down bottom, we got a form. No, that's a facing tool. Wrong job. It faces the first piece and bores it.
Yeah, yeah. You're starting with solid stock here. You're not working with tube stock, right?
No, not with solid stock.
Yeah, so you got to cut that whole center up entirely.
Yeah.
Bearing industry typically use tube stock on a partial size.
Yeah. We got some bearing material down on the end.
Yep.
That we tubing that we run.
Yeah.
We make outer races for bearing.
Okay.
You have to do each position that way.
How long have you been running one of these?
Cones? Let's see, probably 12 years.
12 years. Okay. Takes a little while to learn how to do it.
Yeah. Yeah, you probably won't find many people my age.
Right.
Still in this business.
Unbelievable.
I'm 47 years old.
What's your name?
Michael.
Michael. Okay. Okay, now we'll get the fan turning. I'm just
Before I get into this business, I'm the fan.
This is the other side of the sand machine we've got, and you can see all the rings that are cut off above here. There's another piece that comes down. Okay. How many horses you got on that big motor up here?
I couldn't tell you.
It's got to be a 25 horsepower motor.
25.
I guess it's that. Yeah. Cutting down. Thank you very much, Michael.
You're welcome.
This is for the collets, parts loaded. Yeah.
Yeah. You what? Unchuck it. Take out the butt end.
Gotcha.
Ram a new
new bar in.
Right down through. Bang it in there. Chuck it up. You do that 8 times, then it'll run by itself. You want to see it run?
Sure.
Just stand back or go.
Yep.
Length.
We're checking the length there. Mechanical gauge, yeah. You got diameter, and you got some bore, you got a bore plug there.
Yeah, you go ahead, you lay it down.
Yeah.
And you check the depth of the hole.
Yeah. Right, good.
And then you got a print here, you go by, and you got tolerances.
Sure.
You got your tolerances.
Yeah.
So some of them you got plus or minus 10,000, some of them don't.
Turning tolerances aren't too tight, usually plus or minus 5,000.
On some of the other jobs you got, plus 3, minus 0, and
right.